Blackstone Publishing presents Seeking the Multiverse from the editors of Scientific American. This book is read by Alex Boyles. Introduction. What if? Why us? Why now? Parallel universes are a staple of science fiction, and it's no wonder. They allow us to explore the question, what if, in a way that lets us step completely outside of the world we know, rather than question how that world might have turned out differently. For cosmologists, the question isn't, what if the South won the Civil War, but what if the constants that make up the fundamental building blocks of physics were different? For example, the fine structure constant, known as alpha, is the square of the charge on an electron, divided by twice the permittivity of a vacuum, multiplied by Planck's constant and the speed of light. The number is about 1 over 137. Reduce it by a few percent, and nuclear reactions in stars wouldn't produce carbon. Increase it to 0.1, and stellar fusion couldn't happen at all. Another finely tuned number is the strength of gravity. Too strong, and stars would burn through their fuel far more quickly. If the universe expands too fast, matter would spread out too thin for galaxies to form. Why are there four fundamental forces? Gravity, electromagnetism, with a strong and weak nuclear force. Why not three? It's easy to argue that the numbers have to be where they are for us to be here to observe them, but that still begs the question of why that happens in the first place. The answer might be that our universe isn't the only one. That's the idea explored in this ebook, Possibilities in Parallel, Seeking the Multiverse. In Section 1, we explore why scientists think other universes could exist. After that, we get a look at the implications. Is it possible to have life in a universe with different physical laws? It would seem so. In Cracking Open a Window, George Musser discusses the possibility that our universe has more than three spatial dimensions. The others just happen to be very small. Other articles, including The Universe's Unseen Dimensions, analyze the idea that our universe is one of many brains, three-dimensional structures stretched out over a higher-dimensional space. Our own universe might well be the result of a collision between two brains. The concept of a parallel universe also touches time travel. So, we take a brief jaunt into treatments of quantum theory that allow for it, and make parallel universes necessary, including David Deutsch's and Michael Lockwood's The Quantum Physics of Time Travel. Then, there's the question of what the term parallel universe actually means. It might be a different region of one universe, in principle, reachable if one travels far enough, or another region where a Big Bang took place, a bubble like our own that we can never reach. It's a triumph of the sciences that the very question of why the universe looks as it does can be asked at all. As late as 1920, it was still possible to argue, as American astronomer Harlow Shapley did, that the Milky Way galaxy was the whole of the universe. Widespread acceptance of the Big Bang theory didn't come until the discovery of the cosmic microwave background in 1964. There are currently several possibilities for a multiverse, if it exists. Time and a lot of scientific spade work will reveal which one is right, and get us closer to answering what were once metaphysical questions. What if? Why us? Why now? Jesse Emspach, Book Editor. Section 1. Undiscovered Worlds. Parallel Universes.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.